What if I told you for about $6, I could give you a secret recipe for keeping redness, dull skin, and wrinkles at bay, and also a slight possibility to getting rid of those dark spots at the same time? It's actually no secret at all, because I'm sure by now you've probably already heard of the Ordinary Niacinamide 10% plus Zinc 1%, and the number of people that are finding amazing results with it. It's also no secret at all that this serum has similar effects to retinol, but even gentler on sensitive skin. This video is going to be an in-depth review of one of my favorite The Ordinary products and what you need to know when using it to get the most skin benefits out of it. Hi guys, you've seen our salon media pharmacist here on YouTube. If you guys want to learn more about making informed decisions about your health and wellness in an easy to understand way, then consider hitting that red subscribe button down below to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Also, a super easy way to support the channel is to take 2 seconds to gently tap that like button down below. And since you did like the video, I thought I'd show you a picture of a cute koala. Aww. Now, without further ado, let's get straight into it. If you don't know, The Ordinary is known for making affordable, science-backed skincare formulas that actually work. In fact, just take a look at this product. It contains 10% niacinamide, otherwise known as vitamin B3, which is known to reduce the appearance of skin blemishes and overall skin congestion. But what they also included in the product is zinc PCA as the third ingredient after water and niacinamide. The PCA is pyrrolidone carboxylic acid, and it's been shown time and time again to significantly reinforce skin barrier function, improve skin smoothness, and increase skin radiance over time. That coupled with niacinamide creates a synergy to deliver the results you're looking for just about $6. Talk about value. Now, one of the big questions is who would benefit from this the most? If you're thinking about trying this product out, ask yourself a few questions first. Are you trying to find a way to brighten your skin in general? Maybe shrink pores or lighten newly developed brown spots? If so, then niacinamide addresses all of that. Because research shows niacinamide actually increases ceramide synthesis that results in a stronger, healthier skin barrier and better skin hydration, which is the foundation of healthy, glowing skin. But let's say if you're one to have oilier skin at the same time, well, the zinc that's in it will help normalize your sebum production, as zinc PCA reduces sebum production after 28 days. Or let's say you tried a retinol and didn't like how sensitive it made your skin, or if you didn't have the results you wanted, then this would actually be a good alternative to retinol because it has similar effects of retinol by strengthening the skin barrier and fortifying the skin from the get-go without the sensitivity or irritation, all while providing the same type of antioxidation. Further than this, if you're looking for a product or alternative to retinol that does all that, the Ordinary Niacinamide is a good starting point. And no, this isn't a sponsored video, nor am I paid to promote them. I just am generally a fan of brands that make skincare affordable and effective. One thing that I should mention before going on, which I probably will get a ton of questions down the road, can I use this with my other ingredients? You see, niacinamide is a unique skincare ingredient that gets along with most other commonly used products, including retinol, AHAs, and other antioxidants. But one thing you have to keep in mind is that it does not pair well with vitamin C serums. If you're using a vitamin C for dark spots already, apply them at alternate times, for example, vitamin C at night and this formula in the morning. And this is because niacinamide can affect the integrity of vitamin C, so keep that in mind. And immediately when putting it on, the texture of the serum is super lightweight and you'll notice that it dries pretty fast. I use 2 drops on the left side and 2 drops on the right, and you'll want to use it after cleansing and toning, if toning is your thing, but before you layer on any other serums or moisturizers. So in between your cleanser and moisturizer is when you should use it. And one tip that I recommend is that you should try to use it with the dropper directly on your face, since it begins absorbing right away. Placing it in your hands and then onto your face is going to result in most of the serum absorbing into the skin on your hands first and going to waste. So avoid putting it on your hands first. And one thing that's super important is to make sure your hands are clean before you use it. The dropper can be easily contaminated, so make sure you try your best not to touch the dropper as much as you can. That way you can prevent the spread of germs directly on the dropper. You also want to try your best to hover drop it over your face and not let it touch your face directly. But if it does touch it, the chlorophenicin and the phenoxyethanol in it can help prevent it from contamination to a certain degree, so be cautious of it, but not overly too cautious. There's also two ingredients in this worth mentioning that I don't see others talking about. The first is the Tamarindus indica seed gum, which is why I wonder what could be in it that helps give that velvety glide to my skin. Well, it's actually the tamarind seed gum. It's a polysaccharide that moisturizes and smooths the skin and may in fact improve the skin elasticity. Loss of skin elasticity is known as elastosis, and elastosis causes skin to look saggy, crinkled, or leathery. The tamarind seed gum helps reverse all of that. The second ingredient is the pentylene glycol, which is a multifunctional ingredient. It's great for being an emulsion stabilizer, a solvent, and an antimicrobial, as well as something really unique. It helps to improve the water resistance of sunscreens, which I thought was really interesting. Now, let's say you're already trying a niacinamide, right? Let's say a concentration of 4 to 5%, which by the way is still ideal, as it's still enough to deliver benefits. Higher concentrations like the ordinary 10% have not yet been proven to give you a higher rate of efficacy. So if you're using one now and it's working, it's up to you if you want to switch over to try a new one, but I recommend to stick with what's already working. There's no reason to switch from 4% to 10% if you're already seeing results. But let's say, what if this causes you to break out, or let's say purge, because that's another big concern with starting new products, right? In fact, that's why people don't really start new products, because they worry about the purge. As far as skin purging goes, niacinamide doesn't increase cell turnover, so it doesn't lead to purging. However, if let's say your niacinamide is combined with other agents that do increase cell turnover, like your AHAs, like glycolic and lactic acid, or your retinoids, then yes, the chances of purging are there. But what if it did break you out? Is it possible that the ordinary can still cause a breakout that's maybe not necessarily a purge, but a normal breakout? The answer is yes, it can lead to breakouts. And in fact, it has led to a number of different breakouts for some of its users, while for others, it doesn't break them out at all. And this is because some may have a sensitivity to higher percentages. 10% may simply be too strong for some people, and 4% may work better. Which is why it's always a good idea to patch test new products first before you use them routinely. Also, if you are finding the ordinary too harsh, try using it every other day, as that can actually help offset some of the sensitivities that come with it. I know a big problem that's out there is breaking out with the salicylic acid when you use niacinamide. If this is you right now, try using your salicylic acid on alternating mornings or nights. So one morning you could apply the salicylic acid after cleansing, and the night you can use a niacinamide. But the big question, in terms of how long you can expect results with the ordinary, because that's another question, right? Niacinamide results take 8 to 12 weeks for them to be visible. So give it some time before giving up on the product. Most individuals stop using the product after a week or two, but I encourage you to wait at least 3 months of routine usage, that is of course you have no sensitivity to it, before tossing it and moving on to the next product. This is so you can be more certain that you actually tried the product and not discontinued it too early. If you have any questions, leave them below. I'd be happy to answer them. Also, click that red subscribe button down below and let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section. Seriously, your comments mean so much to me, and I love reading what you guys have to say, even if they are the occasional hate comment I get. Like the video if you did enjoy it, and until then guys, I'll see you on the next one.